Welcome to Big Data Analytics tutorial. In this video, I will discuss Apache Scoop, a tool from Hadoop ecosystem. In real world, there are many sources which are responsible for generating big data. For example, social media sites like Twitter and Facebook, blogs, system logs, IoT application, etc. generate a large amount of data. This large amount of data can be stored and processed using HDFS cluster. Similarly, the traditional application management system is another source for generating a big data. The data generated using traditional application management system is stored in the form of a relational database server in the relational database structure. When data storages and analyzers such as MapReduce, Hive, HBase of Hadoop ecosystem came into picture, they require a tool to interact with relational database servers for importing and exporting the data residing in them. That is, the big data storages and analyzers such as MapReduce, Hive, HBase cannot process the data which is present in RDBMS. Hence, the data need to be imported into HDFS for processing, and the processed data need to be exported back to RDBMS. So there is a need of a tool which can act as a mediator between RDBMS and the Hadoop ecosystem tools such as MapReduce, Hive, HBase and Cassandra. Here comes the tool Apache Scoop. Apache Scoop is a tool designed to transfer data between Hadoop and relational databases. You can use Scoop to import data from relational database management systems, that is RDBMS, into Hadoop distributed file system, that is HDFS. Similarly, the data can be exported from HDFS into RDBMS. Hence, Scoop is also called as SQL to Hadoop and Hadoop to SQL tool. The Scoop name came from SQL and Hadoop. SQ is from SQL, OOP from Hadoop. Scoop can be used with any database, Java database connectivity compliant databases. The databases which are compliant with JDBC connectors can be used with Scoop, and it has been tested with Microsoft SQL Server, Postgres SQL, MySQL and Oracle. There are two versions of Apache Scoop. In version 1, data were accessed using connectors written for a specific databases. For example, if one wants to import and export the data to and from RDBMS to HDFS from MySQL, MySQL related connectors should be used. For example, if one wants to import the data from Oracle to HDFS and HDFS to Oracle, Oracle related connectors should be used. In version 2, instead of using specific connectors which are specific to a databases, a generic JDBC connector was used, which will be an easiest method to import and export the data from different databases. There is no need to use a specific connectors. We can use a generic JDBC connector for transferring, or you can say that importing and exporting the data. This is the pictorial representation of how Scoop works. Scoop has two main tools. One is called as import and another one is called as export. Import tool is used to import RDBMS data into Hadoop file system, and export is used to export the data from Hadoop file system to RDBMS storage. So RDBMS can be MySQL, Oracle, PostgreSQL, DB2, Hadoop file system may be HDFS, Hive, HBase and so on. Now we see how Apache Scoop import method works. The data import in Apache Scoop is done in two steps. In the first step, the Scoop examines the database to gather the necessary metadata for data to be imported. For example, the Scoop tries to extract the metadata information from the RDBMS, such as the database name, tables name, what is the size of the table, how many records are there, who is the owner of that particular database, and so on. Such kind of metadata information will be extracted in the first step. In the second step, Hadoop job is created. In this case, it is just a map only step. There is no reducer step. That is just a mapper map only job that is submitted to cluster so that the actual data transfer can takes place. The one thing we need to note here is whenever we want to import the data from database that is RDBMS to Hadoop cluster, we need to have an access to that particular database. That is the first thing, and the imported data is saved into HDFS directory. Now, the scope will use the database name for the directory. Whenever the data from database is imported into HDFS, the name of the directory will be as same as the name of the database, or the user can specify any alternate directory name if he wants to specify any different name. The second thing is, by default, the data imported from RDBMS will be written into a textual file separated by a comma. Each field is separated by comma, and each record is separated by a new line. For example, let us say that a database has three attributes and two rows. Once it is imported into an HDFS, the data will look something like this. The first field and second, all the fields are separated by comma, and two records are separated by a new line in this case. The user can also specify the delimiter of his own choice. For example, he is not happy with the comma, he can use semicolon, or if you want to use some different delimiter for two different records, for example, by default it is a new line. If you want something else, let us say that rather than you in place of a new line, if he wants to use tab, he can use that also. So that is also possible in this case. Once the data is placed in HDFS, the data is ready for processing. So now we can use this particular data and process it. The pictorial representation of Apache Scoop is shown in this particular diagram. There are two steps. One is called as gathering metadata information from this particular RDBMS. That is the first thing, like what is the database name, what is the table, what is the size of that particular database, and so on. So such kind of information will be gathered in the first step. Once that particular thing is done, a map only Hadoop job is created, and the particular data will be assigned for each and every different maps so that it will be stored into HDFS storage. Now, each of this particular data will be written in the form of a textual file. So, as I told you earlier, like each record is separated by a new line, and each field in the record is separated by a comma by default. Similarly, the data export from HDFS clusters has two steps. First, the database metadata information will be gathered. And then once the metadata information is available, a map only Hadoop job is created so that the data from HDFS to HDFS is written into RDBMS file. First, what Scoop does is it will divide that particular data into different blocks, and these particular blocks of information is assigned to each mapper class, mapper task, so that it will be pushed into databases. So that is what actually happens. Again, one more thing we need to remember: whenever we try to export the data from HDFS to database, the HDFS should have, or you can say that a mapper task should have, an access to database. Without access to database, data cannot be written into we can say that into the database. So this is a pictorial representation of Scoop export method. The first you can say that metadata information will be extracted from the database. Once the metadata information is available, the Scoop use that particular metadata information, that is the can say that database name, again table, and so on, and then it will get the data from HDFS storage, and each of this particular data will be divided into different can say that data blocks. This particular blocks will be assigned to one mapper class, mapper task, so that the data will be pushed into RDBMS storage. Apache Scoop version changes. There are, as we have already discussed, there are two versions, that is version 1 and version 2. The first feature which separates, or you can say differentiate between version 1 and version 2 is the connectors for all major RDBMS were supported in the version 1, but in the second version only the generic JDBC connector was used to import and export the data from RDBMS. In version 1 there was a support for Kerberos security, which will provide some level of security for the import and exported data, and there is no such support in version 2. Data transfer from RDBMS to Hive or HBase is supported in version 1, which is not supported in version 2. First, what we need to do in version 2 is, first the data has to be imported into HDFS, then the data can be loaded into Hive or HBase manually. And the final difference is the data transfer from Hive or HBase to RDBMS. It is not supported in both the cases. If one wants to export the data which is present in Hive or HDFS, is first it should be imported into HDFS and then it can be exported to Scoop. It can be exported to RDBMS. In this video, I have discussed the Scoop tool, which is used for which is used as an intermediator between RDBMS and Hadoop storage. I hope the concept is clear. If you like the video, do like and share with your friends. Subscribe the channel for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.